feel like the South Koreans in Toronto, like, he'll become that guy? You think so?
He has the potential of going down to one of the best Korean fighters that's ever lived. I really genuinely feel that.
It's not gonna go to the decision. It's not gonna go to the decision.
I believe I can become a world champion.
Jesus is in the shape of his life, and now there's a new dog in the park at 135, at 140, and you guys are going to know what time it is very, very soon.
He walks guys down, he never wastes any punches, and from the outside he seems like this nice guy, but when he steps into that ring, he's a killing machine.
Uppercuts. Let's go. Today we're going to be doing drills. We're going to do a lot of drill work. I love doing drill work, partner work. It gives you a little bit of a reality check, you know, of how fast you can slip shots, how fast you can make counters, how fast you can do certain things, right? It's really just updating the software without damaging the hardware, you know? So that's what I love to do, especially, you know, on the off days when you're not sparring, it's still really good work, you know? So good stuff, man.
It's really like, I'm from Korea, so like most of South Korean, when they're a kid, they learn Taekwondo because the Taekwondo is traditional sports in Korea. So there was one gym, the trainer was the former world champion, so my father find that gym, and I went there, the boxing gym. There was a boxing gym, so that's why I started boxing, and when I was 12.
Come on. Keep the hand moving, don't keep the head so flat-sized, yeah? One spot.
And it's important that guys like this are there at the gym that everybody looks up to and wants to be like, you know? We got guys that are about to have their first amateur show this week. And, you know, they look up to Gisu. They see Gisu. They see Mike. They see Maylene. They see them doing their thing. And they're like, yo, I want to do that too. And maybe I can do it better than them. You know what I mean? So it's good. It's a good competition, man. It's good stuff.
I did a few times training with Saul, and I went back to Korea, but Saul sent to me like, yo bro, come to Canada, let's do it. So yeah, sure, let's do it. And came back here and start training with Saul, and it's really amazing.
Set it up with the jab first time. Let's go with the prodigy, yeah?
Oh, I mean, you know, she can learn from the best, right? Gisu is up-and-coming stars, so I would like her to train. And besides, Gisu is southpaw, so, you know, she doesn't get to train a lot of southpaw. So.
If you want, I can raise you up with it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
How
you high?
Yeah, yeah. When I'm like, five.
One to the head.
In this training camp, I focus on boxing, footwork, angles, counter. So, using jab, I just want to focus on more boxing skills, techniques.
That's the work on the show?
Yeah, yeah. In this fight. It's a coming fight, yeah. I will show.
So it's funny that Alexis De La Cruz, he's a rugged Mexican kid. I've seen him actually fight when he fought O'Reilly over here in Barrie. And, he's a strong kid. He's a come forward fighter, but It's gonna be a different story, right? It's gonna be a different story when you fight Gisu. Right now, as you can tell, he just blasted through that 5 rounds. Easy work. He's been in the gym. He's ready to go. But now I'm just picking it up, going for the 5 rounds into that. So he understands now, yo, we're here now. It's time to work. We have 8 weeks. Prepare for this kid.
Stay cool.
Okay.
Come watch me fight. April 27th.
Hello, my name is Gisu. Come watch me fight. April 27th.